Welcome to the third and final programme from what has been so far a rather soggy Southampton Boat Show, but the sun is finally coming out. Now, as we heard earlier in the week, there have been three new models launched at Southampton, and the largest of them is this, the 80 Sport Yacht. And as with every Sunseeker, it's clear that first impressions count. The aft cockpit and huge saloon are at the core of this sport yacht. We often hear of inside-outside space, but what does it actually mean? Well, on the 80, it's immediately clear that it means space. Space to party, space to come and go as you like, room to sunbathe and watch TV, room to entertain without feeling crowded, room to do whatever you want. The seamless full-width saloon doors separate this area, but open them. And you quickly realise that the designers back in Poole understand how people are going to use this boat. Inside, the extensive glazing provides natural light, a feature that continues throughout the boat. But it is above and below that the Sunseeker difference is immediately evident. There is a feeling of quality, of craftsmen who know their stuff. The detail works, the stitching in the leather, the integration of old and new materials that sit alongside each other perfectly. The inclusion of technology that keep the place cool or warm to suit your mood. Everything on this boat is of the highest quality. Close the doors and you become immediately aware of the soundproofing that goes into each and every Sunseeker. In fact, they're class leaders in this field, something you really only appreciate when at sea or cruising. The 80 Sport Yacht boasts an 8-berth arrangement with the option for 2 crew, but every Sunseeker is designed with the market and the client at the forefront. Earlier, I spoke to Sunseeker sales director Sean Robertson to find out what makes Sunseekers so different. Sean, you've got 2 minutes to convince me why the Sunseeker Manhattan 55 is better than the competition.
Well, 2 minutes isn't long.
No.
Because it's a great boat. But let's start. This is probably our first level of yacht, level of Manhattan, where a family are going to take for extended cruising. So more than the long weekend, this is to take her away for a week. Family, guests, friends on board. So what we try and do is all those entertaining spaces have to be maximised. I mean, she's 55 feet, so great length, but still, to get everything you need in that takes a lot of planning. So, cabins alone, we've got a fantastic midships master cabin. You can see the full glazing behind
Beautiful.
Us here.
Beautiful.
So it lets lots of lateral light in.
Yeah.
Good headroom, good size ensuite. You've then got a second cabin forward, the VIP, which again, big glazing still, so it doesn't feel, you're not going to feel the poor relation if you're there as a guest, or if the children are there, it's still great light, great amount of space, again ensuite. And then the third cabin, now maybe that's used for storage, maybe for extra guests, but it gives you that extra bit of space. Fantastic galley on the lower deck, or as certain territories, you know, America we're finding, South America, like to have that up on the top deck, you know, by the patio doors. And serves more as a day galley come bar area as well as, you know, the main cooking. So again, it's very flexible on the layout. Important though, huge entertainment space. I mean, okay, today here is not so nice, but you imagine they're in the Med, in America, you know, full on heat, sunshine. You've got a fantastic entertainment space.
I understand the flybridge on this is huge.
We've really taken, you know, the 53 Manhattan was a great boat, great size bridge, but we've listened to what the clients have said. And when you're in the Med, you're on that beautiful day out by the beach, you want that outside entertaining space. And as much as you've got the platform and the aft cockpit, the flybridge is the place to be. Up and away, bit of protection. You've got great seating up there now. Fantastic double helm seat, big sunbathing space.
Oh, lovely.
Wet bar, you've got everything you need. And just, you can sit up there with 4 or 5 guests and just have a fantastic time. Very easy to use, great space.
Okay.
But let's not forget, we've talked about space, we've talked about cabins and galleys, but it's a Sunseeker.
Yes.
And what a Sunseeker is all about is driving. And this still has more than ever that sports heritage. It is fantastic fun to drive, and that's what we need to remember. Be it a flybridge or a predator, it is fantastic fun to drive.
What about the competition then? What are they going to be saying about this?
What they're trying to say is that they have a bit more headroom or a bigger galley. But you know what? This is the best combination out there. If you look at our competition, no one else offers the complete package of space, outside entertaining space, and the performance. It's the right package at the right size.
Okay, well, I'm quite convinced by that, I'll be honest, Sean. I'm liking the sound of it quite a lot. But what I want to know is then, what about the 68 Sport Yachts?
Let's go and have a look, because that's a totally new niche for us, and I think for the market. So this is the 68 Sport Yachts. This takes the best of what we do in the Predators. So the look, the glazing, the performance, you know, that ultimate sports machine, and just gives a little bit more practicality.
I've got to be honest, when I saw this, I did think Predator.
Yeah, I think we've had probably a similar reaction when we talk to clients about it, when we've had the CGI images that really just don't do it justice. Clients coming here have been absolutely wowed by it. I think in their head, they're thinking Predator 84, 92 that we've done before, with a small, really a helm position, you know, with a couple of bench seats behind. This is a proper flybridge, and you just don't see it in the profile. So client reaction has been fantastic. This suits the client. It may be, you know, they've been with the Predators, they've had the sliding roofs, but want that little bit more from the boat. Maybe a little bit more extended cruising, staying on board, just that bit more space. And this really offers it. You know, you have great platform. So you've got the hydraulic platform here. Still the garage, take a 3.3 meter tender. Good size crew cabin or extra guest cabin, kids cabin, you know, lots of uses for that. And then we go into this fantastic aft cockpit, fixed sunbathing, through to that generous saloon with the lots of light coming in, and all the cabin features we have on the Predator. Three good sized cabins, great galley, flexibility again. We can move the galley to the top deck, depending on the territory, how the client's going to use it. But still, performance, looks, and that flexibility of a bit extra space. A great niche, new for us, and I think it's going to take the market by storm.
And then again, talking about the competition, what do you think they're going to be saying about this?
They're going to be scared. They are really going to be scared. This is that in between, and I think the client that we have that maybe doesn't need all of that space you get from a Manhattan or a yacht, but wants the flexibility of use, this is the boat. And to be fair, look at our competitors, both here in the UK and abroad, there isn't anything. This is a new one for us, new one for the market.
Well, it's very exciting. I'll be honest, after that whistle stop tour, Sean, thank you. No, I'm not 100% convinced which one I want, so I think what I need to do is maybe just go and sit somewhere quietly and have a little think.
Okay.
And it's in the Sunseeker VIP lounge, glass of champagne in one hand, that you can decide which Sunseeker is going to be your next boat. Stuart, Manhattan 55 or 68 Sport Yacht?
Or a 75 or a 73 or a 40 or a 40 metre. It's a very personal decision. It entirely is up to the client to determine what he or she wants and how he wants to have his lifestyle. Personally, I would go for one that I can handle myself, drive myself, berth myself. So I would probably go for a 40 Portofino or a 48 San Remo.
Perfect. I think I would probably go for one that I could sunbathe on. I think that would be my criteria. Now, from what I understand from Robert, the 2013 season has been a really busy one for new launches. In fact, I think we're up to 7 so far this year. So why such a rapid development?
Well, it's the busiest ever year as far as new launches are concerned. And we think it's because that's what the market is looking for. As different territories and different countries and different nationalities are expanding in different cycles, we have to reflect their demands. And we believe passionately that they want the latest new product with new fabrics, new interiors, new finishes, new looks, and we think that will continue for the foreseeable future. Mm. So there'll be no let up from us in new product development.
Good, good stuff. With Southampton obviously drawing to a close, can I ask you how Sunseeker has performed at recent shows?
Well, based on the recent shows, which is Cannes and Southampton, which unfortunately have an overlap, which is difficult for us to manage, but nonetheless, we are very happy with the outturn so far, despite the differentiating factors of weather between Cannes and Southampton. But yes, we're very happy, and the period of time after the close of Southampton Boat Show leads us into see what the actual outturn is as far as sales and conversions are concerned. So very interesting, and I think it's a very interesting market at the moment.
Well, we've still got the final weekend to come, of course, so I can only hope that business reflects the improving weather conditions.
And I'm absolutely sure it will.
And if a wet but drying Southampton isn't quite your cup of tea, then Monaco is just around the corner, where I'm sure the Sunseeker team will be ready to welcome you aboard. Cheers.